Hello everybody, I'd like to introduce myself. My name's Natalie, I'm from North London and I am a victim of non-consensual human experimentation. I know a lot of people in the community call themselves targeted individuals, but I don't like using that term because I haven't done anything wrong to be targeted. I've just found myself living this life for the past 17, 18 years. I'm a single mother of one, and my main reason for sort of trying not to draw too much attention to myself, which is ironic when you consider what's actually happening to me, is to ensure that I maintain care of my child. Initially, when it first started happening, I did go to the police, as you do when you're unaware of what is actually going on. And they referred me to mental health services, who then referred me to social services, who came round to check that I was a good mother and everything was okay with my child, and obviously it was. I haven't had any interaction with them since, but it does scare you. And I know the ramifications of making this video could be quite large, but obviously, when you consider what is actually happening to us, the human rights abuses, and just the effect on your whole being, is psychological torture, isn't it? I can't really remember exactly when it first started happening. I think it was shortly after my mother died. I was living in Islington at the time, and I had the sense of being watched and being monitored, sort of perhaps seeing the same cars or the same motorbikes everywhere I went. No one would say anything to me, but you just had this feeling. And then I had sort of street theatre where people would repeat things that you'd said in conversation. For example, if I said I was going to buy a blue dress from Topshop, I might be going to the shop and you'd hear someone say, "Oh, did you see that nice blue dress in Topshop?" You know, it's all very petty and pathetic, but it's intentional to know that you're under surveillance. So yeah, I had the street theatre. Then I had Brighton, where every time I'd try to go to sleep, I'd get like headlights flash up on my window. I also used to get a lot of car door slamming as I tried to go to sleep. This was before, like now I get verbal abuse, but it's also cowardly that I tend not to pay any attention to it. But initially, it was just car door slamming, so and it would happen sort of like clockwork, like it was timetabled at the exact same time you try to go to sleep, you'd get car door slamming. So I had the Brighton, the street theatre, the car door slamming. Now it's escalated way beyond that. I'd say that sort of 70 to 80% of my street is full up of government whores. I can't think of any other word for them. And having done a lot of research, I know that it happens in a lot of sort of poverty-stricken areas like Haringey and Peckham and Boreham. This is in terms of like places close to London or in London. For those that are new to this or having strange things going on that don't really know what's happening, it does get worse. But know yourself and know your spirit and know that you're so much better than the people doing this to you. I mean, it's so weak, it's so pathetic, it's so cowardly. They have nothing about themselves, as in, no standards, no morals, there's nothing too low. Just when I think they couldn't get any more pathetic, they always surprise me. So, do not overestimate them as human beings, and don't underestimate how low they can go. I'm a mother and I have a child, So you can imagine what's most important to me. These people will follow my child to school, follow me taking him to the park. I mean, I hesitate to call them people. Yeah, it's pretty difficult to cover, obviously, what's happening with me over a 17-year period in sort of 10, 15 minutes, but I shall try my best. So initially, I had the psychological stuff. Then I'd get name calling, but I'd come out to approach the people and I'd have cars drive off, or no one would actually confront me and say anything. So you can imagine telling your friends and family, I've got people hiding from me, calling me names. It does sound like you're a bit crazy, doesn't it? Now it's like my life, all day, every day, regular occurrence. But when you find yourself in this situation, you have to still have a life because you're living, aren't you? Otherwise, you'll become as pathetic as they are. So I still do things. I go out, I see my friends, I try my best. I'm still raising my child. But it does sometimes strike me how complacent I've become with this. But like I said, it's a coping mechanism. And I'll do anything for my child, as I'm sure most mothers will. So if I have to sacrifice myself for that, most good mothers anyway, then I will. But right now, when I initially started researching what was happening, it took about 2 or 3 years for me to work out actually what was happening. I couldn't believe that people could be that evil or that pathetic. Like it's it doesn't sit well with me, and I can understand that mentality. But now I can tell you, some people are so short-sighted and really have no self-respect because they'll allow themselves to do anything. So if they can't respect themselves, they're not going to respect another human being, are they? So I initially started reading up on all the sort of physical things that people were experiencing, and I was experiencing a lot of sound-based sort of torture, a lot of name calling, V2K, UTS sort of name calling. Ask anyone else, did they hear that? No, they didn't. And it happened like over 17 years, as you can imagine. I have travelled extensively. I've been to Barbados, Mexico, I've been Turkey, I've been Morocco, I've been Holland, I've been New York, and everywhere I've been, I've still heard these voices. So that sort of made me 100% certain that I'm implanted. And I have met another victim of this, although her program is slightly different to mine. Mine is more sound based. And strangely enough, we both visited the same dentist based in Tottenham that has now shut down. Whilst we were there, we both had root canal treatment and were put to sleep. So yeah, mine is a lot of name calling and harassment, but it's all overt and covert, where I'll have name calling on my road out in the open, but obviously it's all non-confrontational because these people are cowards. But then I'll also have sort of directed sound. Anything that I am in close proximity to can be used to sort of emit voices of spite. It's quite incredulous, but believe me, sometimes the truth is stranger than fiction. This is a constant, and like I said, I'm sure 70 to 80% of my road are actually involved in it. I've been living here for about 13 years. I can actually pinpoint at least sort of 8 addresses that are close to me that are involved in what's happening to me. But obviously, knowledge is power, and I know that they're trying to bait me into doing something, so I'm determined not to give them the satisfaction. But on the other hand, I do have to try and expose this to any and everybody because I think a lot of people sort of see what's happening with me and believe that it's not their problem, not realizing that this is a problem for the whole of humanity. When you actually get down to the nitty-gritty of it, it's so serious. I mean, obviously, the perps that they choose to carry out their dirty deeds, they haven't got the IQ to sort of think about the bigger picture. I'm also trying to write a book which will cover in more detail actually what's been happening to me over this long period of time. But I thought prior to that, this is the quickest and easiest way to sort of get the word out. You'll see a few more videos on this page. I have sort of so-called men that are supposed to intimidate me by covering up their faces, walking up to the front of my house and sort of mumbling abuse, and then they walk off and get in the. I'm telling you, there's nothing too petty or pathetic for these people. They have no men amongst them, obviously, because clearly real men wouldn't partake in activities that involve them basically selling their manhood to be at the beck and call of pussy ops, as I call them. Yeah, it's a lot. And I know it might sound quite rambling at the moment, but I'm just trying to sort of encapsulate a long period of time in a very short video. But at this present time, my torture has escalated from just sound-based stuff to all sorts of stuff, and it's so predictably weak, sort of heart palpitations, vibrations in my bed, electric shock sensation. I have projected images on occasion, rapid eye movement as I'm trying to sleep, like as my eyes are closed, my eyes will start rolling in my head, overheating, feeling very cold. Yeah, it just gets more and more pathetic. But I'm telling you, if you've got a strong spirit, and I have, there's no way these people can win with me. Like I said, I wouldn't even call them people. They have nothing to them, nothing at all.